Thank you. shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, what his male or female slave, what his ox or ass, or anything else that belongs to him. The word of the Lord. Reading in the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Jews demand signs and Greeks look for wisdom, but we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles, but to those who are called, Jews and Greeks alike, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For the foolishness of God is wiser than human wisdom, and the weakness of God is stronger than human strength. The word of the Lord. Thank you.
Passover of the Jews was near, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. He found in the temple area those who sold oxen, sheep, and doves, as well as money changers seated there. He made a leap out of pots and drove them all out of the temple area with the sheep and oxen, and sealed the coins of the money changers, and overturned their tables, and those who sold doves received them to ease out of fear. Stop making my father's house a marketplace. His disciples recalled the words of the scripture, Zeal of your house will consume me. At this, the Jews answered and said to him, what sign can you show us for doing this? Jesus answered and said to them, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. The Jews say this temple has been under construction 46 years, and you will raise it up in 3 days. But he was speaking about the temple of his body. Therefore, when he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they came to believe the scripture and the word Jesus had spoken. While he was in Jerusalem for the feast of Passover, many began to believe in his name. When they saw the signs he was doing, but Jesus could not trust himself to them because they knew he knew them all, and did not need anyone to testify about human nature. He himself understood it well. The Gospel of the Lord. I've been doing this for some time now. It seems a little bit different. I think last time I did this kind of swimming mass type of mass now. Well, here we are. Father Bema is not able to celebrate mass this morning with us, but he will be here next week. So, for those who are expecting to see Papa Bema, sorry for that, let's start with me today. There's a very famous team of football, we call it soccer, back home. The team is in South Africa, and the name of the team is Bafana Bafana, they call it that. It's one of the biggest teams in South Africa. And a few years ago, they had one of their best players in that team. His name was Deep. And Deep was a very interesting player. So one time, he was Dick Fisher, his name is Dick Fisher. So one time he was interviewed. So tell us the key of your success. You seem to be every time you go to the pitch, the ground, when you're doing so well. So he said, and I don't have any magic way of doing things. But you see, every time when he was supposed to go and play a big match and face his opponents to make a point 3 days before that game, he would go and meet his oldest coach, the coach who told him when he was a little boy. I said, the reason why I was asking him to come train me, because I used to tell him, please train me as a beginner. Don't train me as a professional or whatever, no. I want you to train me as a beginner of football. What I need to know, what kind of decision I need to make, and all those things. And so that's the key of my success. When I'm supposed to come across the bay, be the opponent, I'll go to the drawing board and learn the basic steps of soccer, the basic steps of the game. I want us to take that concept of going back and learning the basics. Today, the first reading from the book of Exodus, chapter 20. Given the basis of our faith, and that basis is 10 commandments. It's, brothers and sisters, sometimes we will get into this complex dynamic of theological ideas of Catholic faith and all these complicated concepts. Sometimes we get lost into that. I'm not trying to say those are not important, they're very important. But sometimes the place we start is the basics. And for those, if you are here, the catechists. About your catechetical book. That's one of the best resources you have. If you have it, you can get it in Amazon, you can get it anywhere. Take that book, read the 10 commandments, read how they're being explained and communicated. And do me a favor. Apart from all we're doing this time of Lent, do one thing. Sit down, go through 10 commandments, one by one, and examine it, every commandment in your life. Sometimes, if you want to be successful, you have to go to the basics. The way that Peter was successful in every game when he had to learn the basics of the game. It's important to pray, to have all these novena, it's important to have devotions, it's important to learn the scripture, but the 10 commandments teaches us the spirituality and the morality of our faith. Reading the 10 commandments. God is exploring the Israelites one thing. He says, if you want to be successful and prosper in your life, observe these 10 commandments. The 10 commandments, brothers and sisters, are not taking. The 10 commandments, they are not taking freedom away from us. In fact, the 10 commandments teach us to. For today's Lent, with the time of all of us to experience the true freedom which God himself offers each one of us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Help me to hear your voice.
of years, maybe a trip to get your mind's father. spiritual teaching began to see our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. We pray for my freedom, graciously grant peace to my enemies. But when the Bible says, may we always pray for sin and save from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, please forgive them and please forgive you. Look not on us, but in the name of Jesus. Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. All God has is in